Hello people, in this video we want to look at dermatophytosis. This is a mycosis, that is, it is a fungal disease and it is caused by trichophyton, microsporum, epidermophyton. These are fungi, these are agents that will cause dermatophytosis. Basically, what is dermatophytosis? It is superficial mycosis, it's a fungal disease. Superficial means it affects the skin, hair, nails, etc. So dermatophytosis is the superficial mycosis. It's a fungal disease. SES, mycosis. M-Y-M-Y-C-O-S-E-S they are using. Okay. Mycosis. It is caused by trichophyton, microsporum, epidermophyton. These are the three fungi which they are named here. These are the agents that can cause dermatophytosis. Okay. So basically, it can also be called as tinea or ringworm infection. There is no worm involved here. It is just fungus. It can be called as tinea. Remember, tinea is worm. Tinea solium, tinea saginata. Those are tapeworms. But here we are talking about tinea. Tinea is fungal. Okay. Ringworm. But there is no worm involved in this. It is fungus. Okay. It is just because it looks like this ring, right? It looks like a ring. That is why they are calling it as a ringworm infection. But all these are because of fungus. Okay. So basically these are capable of infecting the keratinized tissue. Okay. So there can be trichophyton species. This can infect the skin, hair, nail, microsporum and epidermophyton. Basically based on the habitat, you have anthropophilic, zoophilic and geophilic. Anthropophilic means they are exclusive to humans. Let's only focus on this because we are reading what MBBS and we are more concerned with anthropophilic, right? So basically these are fungal species exclusive to humans. Zoophilic means to the animals and geophilic means to soil. Now anthropophilic, what and all are there? Trichophyton rubrum. At least some names you should know, no? Trichophyton rubrum. Then Microsporum adowni, Microsporum adowni, Epidermophyton flocosum. Can you remember these names? Can you say these names? Try to say these names.
Trichophyton rubrum, Microsporum adowni,
and Epidermophyton
flocosum.
Yeah, Epidermophyton flocosum. Not sure why it was so late in reading that. So you remember Trichophyton rubrum, Microsporum adowni, Epidermophyton flocosum. At least these many names you can remember. Let us talk about a word on the pathogenesis, okay? The pathogenesis now. So basically, these are acquired by direct contact, okay? Sometimes when there is humid skin and ill-fitting underclothing, like underwear and all, if they are very ill-fitting, tight-fitting, then these spores can infect and cause this fungal infection. Skin, especially skin, there is a growth in centrifugal pattern, annular or ring-shaped will be there. That is why it is called as this ringworm probably. They have raised edges, okay, scaling, erythema, rarely blister formations can be there. So what and all you saw, direct contact, humidity, humid skin, ill-fitting clothes, ill-fitting undergarments especially. Right, then, so the skin basically you saw ring will be, the ring with the raised edges, annular ring, blister formation, scaling, erythema, nails, what will happen? It will invade the nails and lateral or superficial nail plates, it will invade and then it will spread to the whole nail. Then hair, it can either invade the hair or it may be just on top of the hair, right? So basically based on that you have the ectothrix and the endothrix. So basically in the endothrix where it is entering the hair, there can be alopecia, patches of alopecia, hair loss can be there, okay? Males are affected more because in females they are protected by progesterone. Then based on the immune status also the person is affected. Some people are more prone to this because of their immune status, okay? So let us look at the clinical types of dermatophytosis. spermatophytosis, clinical types. So clinical types means you have very easy ones we will tell you here. Remember, it is tinea, okay? T-I, tinea. So if the scalp of this guy is involved, it is tinea capitis. So the scalp is involved in tinea capitis. Ectothrix, endothrix, you already saw these words based on the hair shaft, right? Now if the face is involved, the non-bearded part of the face, that is tinea facei, tinea facei. If the beard and mustache are involved, then it is called as tinea barbae, okay? Then if the nails are involved, hands and nails. If the hands are involved, manum. If the hands are involved, it is called manum, guys. And if the nails are involved, it is tinea unguium. Okay, if you can remember that. At least hand you remember, manuum. Corporis means entire body is affected, right? If body is affected, it will be corporis. If the groin is affected, it is cruris. Cruris means groin is affected. Then pedis means web space between the toes are involved. Okay, pedis. So let us look at what next topic here is, dermatophyted or ID reaction. What is this dermatophyted or ID reaction is? Okay, so basically ID reaction, they may ask you in the exam, you should tell what ID reaction is. Basically hypersensitivity to dermatophyte antigen. This is again a hypersensitivity reaction to the antigen, right? This has nothing to do with this fungal growth on the skin or something. This is more because of the circulating dermatophyte antigen will cause a hypersensitivity reaction. So this will not be in the place of this ringworm. Somewhere else there will be, because of the circulating antigen it can be, okay? So that is nothing but ID reaction, you have understood, right? Now let us move on to the dermatophyte's lab diagnosis. Okay, dermatophyte's lab diagnosis. Here you have very specific diagnostic names. Woods lamp examination. Certain dermatophytes, you see, fluorescence, okay, they fluoresce when infected lesions are viewed under this Wood's lamp. So, they have this fluorescence effect, okay, due to presence of this pteridine pigment in cell wall, okay. So, you should see under which lamp? Wood's lamp. They have what? The presence of pteridine pigment in the cell wall. So you just take these skin infections and look at them under the Wood's lamp. Okay, it's usually positive for the trichophyton and the microsporum. Trichophyton and microsporum will show this, not the epidermophyton. They're saying usually positive for trichophyton solenni, if you want, you can remember that, and for microsporum species, okay. So basically for these, what will happen under the Wood's lamp, you have to see Wood's lamp, you should not forget Wood's lamp, under the Wood's lamp. This is kind of an image showing the fluorescence, okay. Then standard stuff you can write, specimen collection. So you collect the specimen, right, like skin scraping, hair plucks, nail clippings you can obtain, and you should not cut the hair, you should pluck the hair, okay? That's what they're saying, you should pluck the hair. But nail clipping you can take, and you can directly examine, okay? You can examine on the KOH mount. So basically what you will do, you'll take 10% KOH, right, for skin scrapings, and for hair you can put 10%. For nail you have to put 20 to 40%. Why? Because you need more concentration to dissolve the tissue, right? So for skin and hair, just 10% KOH is enough. Then you have to see it. You can either stain it or see it, okay? So what will you see? Septate hyphae. Why will you see septate hyphae? Because you have already seen in the classification that dermatophytes come under molds and they'll have hyphae. Like you can see here, hyphae, right? You will see septate hyphae, not just hyphae, you will see septate hyphae, they're saying, right? And when these hyphae all get mixed up, it will become like a mycelium. So basically, you should see the hyphae, okay? Going back here, so remember KOH 10% for dissolving skin and hair. and 20 to 40% to nail. Okay. Then septate hyphae you will see. Then with arthroconidia. With arthroconidia. Why will you see conidia? See, in the classification you already have seen that it is ascomycetes, right? Dermatophytes, at least the first two, that is the trichophyton and the microsporum, they are coming here and they will have conidiospores, right? The spores which are asexual are conidiospores, macrospores and microspores. Now, the epidermophyton comes in the fungi imperfecti, but they also have conidiospores. So, conidiospores you should mention, asexual reproduction, conidiospores. So, if you are finding this arthroconidia on top of the hair shaft, that is ectothrix, and if it's fine, you're finding this within the hair shaft, it's endothrix, right? Then let us move on to culture. Let's take a new page and put culture. Now, what are we studying today? Dermatophytosis. Okay? Guys, how's it going so far? Do you want a wake-up call or what? You're going good, right? You're understanding. So don't worry, we have already reached the culture. It's not going to be very far, right? We'll finish it off. So you will inoculate these into what agar? Saboyuraud dextrose agar, SDA agar, you will inoculate it. So you will keep it at 28 degrees centigrade for 4 weeks. Can you imagine? You have to keep it for 4 weeks at 26 to 28 degrees centigrade. That's more like room temperature, right? So, in room temperature. So, you will keep it for 4 weeks and then you will put some potato dextrose agar to stimulate the sporulation. Okay, then you will check the colonies, the growth rate, the texture, pigmentation, colony topography, and they have to decide what type of growth it is. Okay, so basically, see if you can understand here. Basically, here we are showing here trichophyton. Okay, this is for trichophyton. See, trichophyton, this is trichophyton. Abundant microsconidia are there. Trichophyton, this is how it will be on SDA agar. Okay, then coming to microsporum. Here you have microsporum, and this is how microsporum will look on the SDA. Then here you have the epidermophyton and epidermophyton, how it looks. Okay. Let's look at this. In microsporum, right, in microsporum, the microconidia are rare. So this is microsporum. In microsporum, the microconidia are rare. Okay. The trichophyton has lot of microconidia. Trichophyton has lot of conidia. Okay. So it has lot of microconidia, guys. Look at this diagram and tell, guess which is ectothrix. Ectothrix means outside the hair shaft. Very good. Which is endothrix? Very good. What do you think the microconidia of trichophyton looks like? Something like this. Microconidia of trichophyton. Yes. Then, what is this you think? This is called as racket hyphae. Okay, racket hyphae. Then, this is a chandelier. Favic chandelier. This one is some kind of a spiral hyphae. So basically a lot of things that you have learnt now. Let us look at. These are the mounts actually. See, it's written here. LPCB mount. LPCB means lactophenol cotton blue mount. See, it's blue. Cotton blue mount. Okay. There are a lot of other ways of diagnosis also for dermatophytosis. So, a lot of other ways of diagnosis. You have like hair perforation test. You have urease test. Dermatophyte test medium is there. Dermatophyte identification medium is there. Molecular methods like PCR, you will write standard. Okay. Then you will write skin test to check the hypersensitivity to the antigen. Basically, in hair perforation test, you will use a petri dish which contains hair, water, etc., yeast extract, and you will put the inoculation and see whether this fungi will pierce the hair. Urease test is positive for some trichophyton. Then you have the dermatophyte test medium. dermatophyte identification medium, etc. Okay. So let's then continue to dermatophytosis. What is the treatment? Okay. You can mention itraconazole, ketoconazole, etc. Okay. Orally, actually, these are given, though not topical here. You can pay attention. Oral itraconazole. So that's all now in this dermatophytosis chapter. We will meet you in the next video, guys. Just take a silent recap. Classification, pathogenesis, clinical types, ID reaction, lab diagnosis, culture, LPCB mount, other tests like urease test, hair perforation test, molecular method, skin test, treatment, itraconazole. Okay. We will meet you in the next video, guys. Take care, take rest, and come back. Bye-bye.